plain substance. It's the material form or sheath of a great diva. The essence back of manifestation and the soul of the plane. THEFACTOROFMANAS 489. Postulate 2. All forms, vibrating to any keynote, are fabricated by the building devas out of the matter of their own bodies. Hence they are called the Great Mother Aspect, for they produce the form out of their own substance. Postulate 3. The devas are the light which produces form cohesion. They are the third and second aspect blended, and might be considered as the life of all forms that are subhuman. A magician, therefore, transmutes in the mineral kingdom works practically with diva essence in its earliest form on the upward arca. Evolution, and has to remember three things. A. Heredity. B. C. The effect of the backward flow of the involutionary lives which lie back in the mineral, or, in effect, is sevenfold nature of the peculiar group of devas which constitute its being in an occult sense. The next transition stage is head into the vegetable kingdom, or the occult effect of the second kingdom on the first. Postulate IV. All diva essences and builders on the physical plane are peculiarly dangerous to man, for they work on the etheric levels and are, as I have earlier pointed out, the transmitters of prana, or the vital, animating substance, and hence they set loose upon the ignorant and the unwary, fiery essences burns and destroys. Postulate B. The devas do not work as individualized conscious units through self-initiating purposes as does a man, a heavenly man or a solar logos viewed as egos, but they work in groups subject to A. B. C. Inherent impulse, or latent active intelligence. Orders issued by the greater builders. Ritual, or compulsion induced through color and sound. 490 ATRE ATISE on cosmic fire. When these facts are remembered and considered, some comprehension of the place the devas play in transmutation may be achieved. The position that fire occupies in the process is of peculiar interest here, for it brings out clearly the difference of method between the two schools. In the transmutative processes carried on by the Brotherhood, the inner fire which animates the atom, more and more man is stimulated, and in strength until it through its own internal potency burns up its sheath, and escapes by radiation from within its ring path knot. This is seen in an interesting way as occurring during the process of the final initiation when the causal body is destroyed by fire. The fire within burns up all else and the electric fire. bad position. The light or entity concerned receives a setback. The divots work constructively and without participation in the purpose of the plan, and the magician is in danger under the law of karma and through the materializing of his own substance by affinity with the third aspect. Black magic of this nature creeps into all illusions along this very line of the destruction of the form through outer agency, and not through the liberation of the life through inner development and preparedness. It produces the evils of Hatha Yoga in India, and similar methods is practiced in certain religious and occult orders in the Occident also. Both work with matter on some plane in the three worlds, and do evil that good may come. Both control the devas and attempt to produce specific ends by manipulation of the matter of the form. The hierarchy works with the soul within the form and produces results that are intelligent, self-induced, and permanent. Wherever attention is centered on the form and not on the spirit, and they tend to show their evil worship, like the contact in black magic, for the form is made of viva substance on all planes. This must be considered well in connection with every form, for it holds the key to many mysteries.
Energy
lying down with the lamb. This comment, the little child shall eat them, is largely the esoteric enunciation of the fact that three-fifths of the human family will stand upon the path. A little child, being the name applied to probationers and disciples. In the vegetable and mineral kingdoms, a corresponding demonstration will ensue, and it is such a nature as to be too obscure for our comprehension. The central factor of solar fire in the work of transmutation will come to be understood through the study of fire devas and elementals, who are fire, and who are, in themselves essentially and through active magnetic radiation, the external meter vibration which produces the force which plays upon the spheroidal wall of the atom. The response within the atom which produces radiation or the escape of volatile essence. Speaking cosmically, and regarding the solar system as itself a cosmic atom, we consider that the abstractions of entities who indwell the former, electric fire, the material substance which is enclosed within the ring cast not moving it is a homogeneous whole, is fire by friction. The fire devas from the cosmic mental plane, the Humagni and Indra are the embodiers along with one whose name is not to be given, are the external agencies who carry on cosmic transmutation. This triple statement can be applied to a team, a chain, or a pair also, remembering ever that in connect. 62 Bible, Isaiah 11, 6. 494 ATREATISE on cosmic fire. Tion or man the fire which is the third aspect emanates from the systemic mental. We have dealt in broad and general manner with this question of electricity and have seen that fire essence or substance is resolved through internal activity and external heat in such a manner that the electric fire at the center of the atom is liberated and takes a new form. This is the aim of the transmutative process and the fact that hitherto alchemists working in the mineral kingdom have failed to achieve their objective has come due to three things. First, inability to contact the central electric spark. This is due to ignorance of certain of the laws of electricity, and above all, ignorance of the set formula which covers the range of the electrical influence of that spark. Second, inability to create the necessary channel along which the escaping light may travel into its new form. Many have succeeded in breaking the form so that the light has escaped, but they have not known how to harness or guide it, and all their labor has consequently been lost. Third, inability to control the fire elemental or the external fire which affects the central spark through the medium of the environment. Required. environment on the physical plane. From now on, the trend of activity will be towards the understanding of the subjective side of manifestation, and towards the comprehension of the psyche of the individual life, divine, planetary, or human. In the next round, all the previous stages will be recapitulated, and Manas will demonstrate. In ways inconceivable as yet to the half-awakened consciousness of man. In that round, three bits of the human family will be fully aware, functioning with uninterrupted continuity of recollection on the physical, astral, and lower mental planes. The emphasis of manifest evolution will be laid upon the achievement of consciousness, and upon the scientific construction of the bridge which should unite the causal vehicle and the permanent manasic atom on the abstract level. During the sixth and seventh rounds, we shall again have the synthesizing process observed in a manner analogous to that which lies ahead in the sixth and seventh group races of this round. Express the whole matter in larger terms, the heavenly man will be achieving the consciousness of his causal body on cosmic levels, the consequent reaction, repolarization and alignment of this body of manifestation. Under the law, this will work out as demonstrated quality and ordered intelligence purpose in every kingdom of nature, and will produce unifying results within those kingdoms, kind and explicable to man at his present stage of manasic development. We need not, therefore, give further time to the consideration of them, for the mental concept of man does not measure up to the magnitude of the theme. In summing up what I have written in this matter of the discriminative faculty, the intelligent activity, the adaptability nature, and the transmutative power of mana, I would like to point out that so varying are these developments that every department of nature